powerful stewards of the land and to respect the cultures, ceremonies, and traditions of all who call it home. As we open our hearts and minds to the past, we commit ourselves to working in a spirit of truth and reconciliation to make a better future for all. Everything that you need for this morning's service is going to be up on the screens, and we're going to begin with our opening hymn, which is Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Rise among you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on your nurses' hands. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you. The young camels of Midian and Ephah, and all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The refrain for Psalm 72 is, "All nations shall serve you." Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the king's son, that he may rule your people righteously and the poor with justice, that the mountains may bring prosperity to the people and the little hills bring righteousness.
All nations shall serve you.
He shall defend the needy among the people. He shall rescue the poor and crush the oppressor. He shall live as long as the sun and moon endure, from one generation to another. He shall come down like rain upon the bottom of the field, like showers that water the earth. In his time shall the righteous flourish. There shall be abundance of peace till the moon shall be no more. The kings of Tarshish and of the Isle shall pay tribute, and the kings of Arabia and Sabaoth offer gifts. All kings shall bow down before him, and all the nations do him service. For he shall deliver the poor who cries out in distress, and the oppressed who has no helper.
All nations shall serve him.
He shall have pity on the lowly and poor. He shall preserve the lives of the needy. He shall redeem their lives from oppression and violence, and dear shall their blood be in his sight.
From the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. This is the reason that I dwell in a prisoner for Christ Jesus for the sake of you and the Gentiles, for surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that is given me for you, and now the mystery was made known to me by revelation. As I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to mankind, as it has now been revealed to those holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body and sharers in the promise of Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel I have become a servant according to the gift of God's grace that was given me by the working of all his power. Although I am very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery for ages in God who created all things. So that through the church, the wisdom
according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And in the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." And while King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. And they told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' And when Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared, and then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage.' And when they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star, that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. And on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and they gave him homage. And then opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. The Gospel of Christ. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. So as I thought about what points us to God, us to how Jesus lived his earthly life, how he calls us to live our lives now. They give us guidance about how to live lives of compassion and love and mercy and empathy, and how important it is to reach out to those who are in need. And whatever that need is, that whatever they're lacking, to give them a fulfilled life, we are called to reach out. So I think the Gospels is what really points us to Jesus. Secondly, I thought about was our prayer time. How much time do we spend in prayer with God? Do we spend time talking, but also spend time listening? Often we forget that listening part. But prayer is a conversation that goes two ways. We can't be the ones that are doing all the talking, because if we do, we'll miss God's message to us. So we need to talk, and we also need to listen. And also, I think, if we're going to live a life of following God, following Jesus, we need to be a part of a supportive group of fellow believers, people who also have faith, who also believe, who will love us unconditionally, support us when we start to fall, and will kind of drag us back when we start to go astray. Because it's really hard to be a Christian in this world today, because we are far and few between, and we do need support. I remember years ago when I took part in the Crusade, and I remember one thing that they told us is that you can't be a Christian by yourself. It might be easier sometimes. You might think it's easier sometimes not to put up with other people. But we all need support. We need someone on the journey with us, because sometimes we don't see ourselves going astray. So we need someone who will be able to point that out to us, to give us back on this right part, right path. Sometimes other people can be our stars that shines that light in the places that we can't quite see ourselves. So the things that point us to God are the Gospels and our prayer life and our support groups. So I think those are our stars in this life. And also, again, I talk about what gifts do we bring. The people who visited Jesus that day, they got to gold and frankincense and myrrh. I seen a little thing on Facebook that said if it was three wise women, they probably would have bought diapers, formula, and potluck or casserole. Practical gifts. But the gifts that they did receive were very symbolic of who Jesus was. So what gifts do we bring to God? You know, because we still have something to give. Even though there's not a baby in the manger, God is still here. Jesus is still here. So what do we bring? And I thought one of the most important things we bring is ourselves. We are flawed, we're broken, we're imperfect. And God did not want perfect people. And if we read through the Bible, we'll see the Bible is full of imperfect people. People who make mistakes. People who do things wrong. People who hardly ever get it right. But these are people who God uses. God did not look for the perfect people when he looked for the people to serve him. But I think in our brokenness, we realize we're not perfect. And that's the people that God needs, not people who are full of themselves, who think they got it all right, who think that they're better than everybody else. Because those are people that God can't use. It's probably too much work. But so when we realize how broken and flawed we are, that we are more compassionate to the flaws of others, that we can accept people as they are, instead of being all judgy and critical, because that's not what Christian community is about. Christian community means loving people as we are, flawed and broken all the same. The second gift I think that we bring to God is our willingness to live lives according to the example that Jesus left for us. To live lives of compassion and love and mercy and empathy and forgiveness, and the list goes on and on about how Jesus called us to live. Being able to be with people who are in need, being able to love them all the same, with be able to recognize, like I said, our own brokenness in the midst of debt. And the third thing I think that God, the gifts that we bring, is our longing for God. Does anybody long for God? And often I have this longing inside of me, you know, this desire to be closer to God. I try as I might. Some days it's not easy, and other days are. But I have inside of me this longing to be in God's presence, the longing to do what God wants me to do. And I think God really wants our longing. He wants our desire. And when we can bring that to Him, that's when God is most pleased with our actions, I believe. Because we are in a world where people desire a lot of things. They desire popularity and power and money and control. And all of these things that have led us into this broken world that we're in today. But when we long for God and long for that kingdom of heaven here on earth, you know, the place where we are all loved, where we're all belong, where we can be ourselves, not just have it fit in, but belong because we are God's creation. Guess what? That's a beautiful gift to bring. So our three gifts are ourselves, our willingness to live our lives according to His will, and our longing for God. And I believe that's probably the greatest gifts that we can bring. And if we have that, everything else kind of falls in place. So when they followed the star, the wise men, they found Jesus. When we follow the way of God, we find the kingdom of earth. The earth has come down here. The kingdom of heaven has come down here to earth, I should say. And our lives are so much better. I know it's not easy. It's not an easy path of what God calls us to do, but it's well worth it, for sure. Today, little Reese has been brought here by her family. And we want Reese and her little sister Grace to grow up in a world that's surrounded by love. As long as they're home with their families, that is what they'll experience. They'll be loved, they'll be appreciated, they'll be taught good things in life. But someday they'll go out on their own. Once you hit kindergarten, I'm sorry, parents are. Our control of our children kind of slacks off a little bit once they get in school. And they begin to interact more with people in the other world, outside our homes. So we want them to live in a world where they're surrounded by love, where they're always treated with compassion and mercy. So we do that by changing one heart at a time. We change our own, we change the hearts of the people around us. And the world becomes a kinder place for these little ones who are just beginning their lives. So I pray for each and every one of you here that you will always choose the way of love. Choose the way of how Jesus taught us to live. And may Jesus be our guiding star, always pointing us in the right direction. And all this I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So now we have some very important work to do, don't we, Grace? Yeah. Because Grace is starting out her life as being a Christian today. She's going to go through the waters of baptism. And her parents and her godparents have all made very important, are going to make very important promises on her behalf. Promises that they made on your behalf, Grace, when you were just a little baby too. Yeah. So, screen what the godparents and the parents, I'm going to ask you to open up your books, because when we go over to the font, you're not going to be able to see screens. So it's on page 153 in your books, and it's been halfway down through. So on page 153, I'm going to ask you all now, with the parents and godparents, if you would all stand up. And if you can present a brief lease of her baptism. Halfway down here, you would say, I present. And I'll say that together. Yep, I'm looking for it. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is nurtured in the faith and life of the Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? You renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God. You renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God. And you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God. You turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior. You put your whole trust in his grace and love. And you promise to obey him as your Lord. Thank you so much. And I'm going to ask everyone else here to stand up, because Reese's parents and godparents can't do all of this on their own. They need the support of a Christian community that can help them to guide them along their faith. So when you can witness these vows with all in your power, support this person in her life in Christ.
Amen.
Thank you. So now I'm going to ask Tanya if she would come forward, and she's going to lead us in the prayers for Reese.
Deliver her, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open her heart to feel your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill her with your Holy Spirit and life-giving Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach her to love others and the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send her into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring her to the fullness of the peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ your sin may live in the power of his resurrection and hope for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen.
Thank you, Tom. So now I'd like to raise the staff and sponsors to come over around the front, and we'll come over to do the next part of our baptism service. So Grace, I asked Grace earlier if she could help me with the water. Do you think you can help me with the water? Come on over. Praise and honor and worship through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Let us now join with Reese, who is committing herself to Christ, and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Holy Spirit. He descended to the dead. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostle teaching and fellowship in the breaking of bread and in prayers?
I hold with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human person or human being?
I will with God's help.
And will you strive to safeguard the integrity of God's creation, respect, sustain, and renew the life of the earth?
I will with God's help.
Thank you. We'll now go back to our seats and we'll have our offertory hymn, which is Away in the Manger. Gracious God, accept the offering of your church, the hearts of your people joined in praise and thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Christ, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to to reconcile us to you, the God, Father of all. He healed the sick and ate and drank with outcasts and sinners. He opened the eyes of the blind and proclaimed the good news of your kingdom to the poor and to those in need. In all things, he fulfilled your gracious will. On the night he freely gave himself to death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Gracious God, his perfect sacrifice destroys the power of sin and death, and by raising him to life, you give us life forevermore. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Recalling his death, proclaiming his resurrection, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you, Father, this bread and this cup. Send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that all who eat and drink at this table may be one body and one holy people, a living sacrifice of Jesus Christ our Lord. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Oh.
deep within your heart. May God bless you with anger and injustice, oppression, and the exploitation of people, so you may work for justice and freedom and peace. May God bless you with tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, rejection, starvation, and war, so you may reach out your hand to them and turn your pain into joy. And may God bless you with enough foolishness to believe you can make a difference in this world, and that you can do what others say cannot be done. Amen. Well, God bless you all. Thank you all for coming here to worship today, as we're in the close of another year. Another year is coming on, and all the blessings and joys and pain and suffering that has come with that, because life is a combination of both, isn't it? If you didn't pick up our orders or a bulletin on the way in, it's on the blue sheet of paper on the table on the back of the pews on the white side going out. You're welcome to take part in our worship service next week at St. John Evangelist Church in Coley's Point. It'll be at 10:30. And other announcements coming up in this month is all written in your order of service. Is there any birthdays this week coming up, or anyone you've missed in the last couple of days? All grown to the 2nd of January, okay. My dad's birthday is today, actually. So New Year's Eve is always a birthday celebration for my dad, so we'll get together later to have cake and celebrate his birthday. Any other birthdays? Okay, well, God bless you all. I hope tomorrow is the beginning of a wonderful year. May the year be a year of blessings for all of you. We're going to close now with our closing hymn, which is